everybody. Good morning, or good afternoon, or good evening, depending on what time it is for you where you are. I am shocked that I managed to get the stream launched. Kitty Cat was like walking on the keyboard, and then you were sitting on the keyboard, and then you were headbutting my mouse hand. And I think you were trying to turn the stream on for yourself because you were like, Mom, you're not going to do it. You're late. That's true. I was late. Hi, everybody. Happy Thursday. Welcome back to a fresh, bright, shiny, brand new Hazel stream. And today I want to make a choice to begin the grind. Also, I think it's cute that our hair kind of matches a little bit. I want to log into this, and I just want to have a look at it, because I need stuff. Happy New Year! Happy New Year! Aloha. We've also got coffee that we need to drink, and Kitty Cat, you need... What do you need? Attention. How many 70s? I have 17 level 70s. As it happens. So, this one is a druid. She's my night elf druid. I have many druids, apparently. I have a Kul'tiran Barnaclus. He's geared up for Rusto for PvE. I have Petalbloom. She's a high mountain tauren. I leveled her to get Heritage Armor. There might be more, but those are the ones that come to mind. However, this character has a special purpose. And in recent years, her special purpose has been to, at the very least, farm herself up a vicious mount. And the current season vicious mount looks like this. It's an owl beast. And I don't think, correct me if I'm wrong, because I would love to be wrong, I don't think there are any other owl beasts that you can have as mounts in the game. It's an available model for druid bear form. But as far as mounts go, unless I miss something in the Emerald Dream, this is it. This is the one. There's this and then I'm assuming the Horde version, which might be a different color, but like, well, it must be a different color. This one's very blue and yellow. Anyways, this is the Dragonflight Season 3 Vicious Mount. And I need it. So today's the day. I gotta figure out my life. The good news is that you don't have to figure out much of your life to work on this. It's really more of a persistence thing than it is a skill thing. Because you just need to be winning games at or above 1k PvP rating. And this can be done in solo shuffle. So what I'm thinking for today is I'm going to drink a bunch of coffee. I'm going to poke around online and see if I need to like change my talents, because it's a new season, so they might have changed something. I don't know if I can get away with last season's talents. These were the talents that I did arena in last season. And then I also don't know how bad my gear is, but it's certainly out of date. Like I have full PvP gear from last season, but they have once again done the thing where they've rolled it over, so gotta gear up again. Which is all a lot. And Kitty Cat, I love you, but you're a little bit in front of my monitor. I guess that's fine. We can see over you. You're a little bit in front of the camera, too. That's good, too. I approve of using druids as mounts. Morning, people in the computer. Morning, computer people. Solo world PvP. Oh, man. What is your preferred leveling up preference these days? I like leveling in old classic zones with Cataclysm. Just questing through them, but that's just because I'm comfy there. I love to see you do a Minecraft Let's Play series. That would be a plot twist. Yeah, everything does start with coffee. At least her transmog's gorgeous. I don't even think she's monked. I think that's the set. Oh no, I must be monked because I think that I'm wearing. Yeah, we mogged to the elite color. I want to say, just to show off. It would be nice if we got the elite set again, but I prefer to set no goals when it comes to this kind of thing and then just kind of enjoy things if they happen. Morning, Miss Hazel. Good morning, Lizard. How you doing? Alright. First things first. You ever in school, and you're learning how to type, and they've got like a typing class, and they cover up your keyboard so you can't see it to make you prove that you know how to touch type? It's like that, but with a cat. Like, I know how to type, and I'm sure I can touch type after all of these years. Also, she's stealing the focus, as she should. But it makes you second guess yourself a little bit when there's a cat in the way. I want to look up, I don't know if this is going to help. Normally, the way that I get talent builds for PvP is... The normal way that I get talent builds for PvP is to just, like, ask Flabby who the good druid is, and then go on their armory and then take their talents. But I want to try something different this time around. So I'm poking around subcreation. I don't know if this is where you find answers, but it's an option. For PvP solo shuffle, we're S tier. That's good news. That's a good start. We like that. What I want, though, is talents. More resources? These are tier lists. Drustvar. That must be something. PvP leaderboards. Arena logs. Arena logs. Oh, no. Absolutely not. What do I want to do? I mean, I could just play in my same talents that I had last season. Show me the leaderboard. Because we want to find a Resto Druid. Oh, Druid Restoration Talents. Okay, well, this is like a kind of obnoxious way of looking at it, but I can cross-reference this versus my talents to see. You know, you can see that like 100% of people take this Ironbark talent, for example. So I can stick this in a monitor and I can just have a little look-see and make sure it's all more or less right. Oh, hi, Stumpy, thank you for the 10-month resub. Yeah, I'm just gonna scoot this and have a little look at my talents if we can get enough monitor for that. So on the druid side of things, if I scroll down to the capstone, I'm specced in Nature's Vigil, which people tend to not do. It looks like we want to drop that and take Heart of the Wild. Based results above. Oh, hang on. This is all druids on the leaderboard of any bracket. I need to filter it so that we can only get the high-rated ones. Or at least the medium rated ones. Ratings. Leaderboards. Let's do solo shuffle for US. And then I want advanced filters. Minimum rating, yeah. So in... Let's do a minimum rating of like... I guess the minimum rating you can set is 2K. Exclude players that have not logged in the last month. That's good. So now there's 187 players left. All right. So we're still looking at Heart of the Wild. Renewal's good. Well-honed instincts, good. This is the most backwards way of doing talents I've ever seen in my life. About half of people take Mass Entanglement over Vortex. Interesting. Improved Rejuve, good. Stampeding Roar, Mighty Bash. This seems all fine. There's an argument to be made for this side of the tree, but no, we definitely get to that. Oh, Cyclone's in the Druid tree. For some reason, I thought for sure that it was elsewhere. Sunfire, which bizarrely enough is down by Soothe. Is this an old version of the talents? Because like this is new. They've moved this. Lots of people used to take a Sunfire talent here. Okay, Rising Light Falling. So I need this talent. It's gonna give me, I don't know what it turns into in PvP, but something. Well, now I'm confused. This is the worst possible way of doing this. As long as we have photosynthesis, good. Undergrowth, good. Can you take 3 capstones? Verdant Infusion, good. Yeah, I think it's fine. So we could dip out of this and go into this, and then go into that. That seems more popular. To get extra Tree of Life's. Although, how user-friendly is that? I don't know. We'll play with it. we'll try it. Like I said, we're not trying to push anything, really. We're just trying to play, so... Call the talents good. Are my keybinds all right? I'm sure my keybinds are fine. Right? What could I have possibly changed? I have Heart of the Wild now. What am I going to do with that? Physical damage? Probably use it for defensively for bear form, extra stamina. I would like to thank Ahoy Stumpy for a 10-month resub. Appreciate it very much. a holocron coder for a 16-month Risa Pay Hazel. Hope all is well. Camera seems to prefer the kitty's head to yours. Indeed. Thank you very much. And Karama with a 40 stream streak. I might be overcompensating for the fact that I can't watch streams during the weekday outside of college vacations. Don't you have to press Heart of the Wild? I don't understand. What are we doing today? I am in a somewhat confusing sort of way, trying to set up my druid to do some casual PvP this season in pursuit of the vicious moon beast, which I require. My gear, my PvP animal is 450, which is basically just last season. If we look at the honor quartermaster, because I... Oh, and you have to craft stuff. I don't wanna... Yeah, so I can get a big upgrade just by spending my honor to buy gear, which is great. That's good news. We like that. Love to hear it. The trouble is which pieces to buy. Because I don't want to buy anything that's going to be in like a crafted slot. I don't know what I'm crafting. I'm already so over this. Okay, maybe I need to go back to plan A, which is to look on the leaderboards and find somebody to copy their gear. Because we're deep enough in the season now that people should be wearing stuff. So let's try that. WorldofWarcraft.com. Game info. We are zoomed in way too far. And also, you guys can't see this. Let's reset that. Hi, kitty cat. Oh, I got you. I got you. Meow. It's in my lap. Green kitty skin in-game, please. Hello, Hazel. Hello, Amaya. How are you doing today? We want... All right. So I was going to poke around and see community PvP leaderboards. And I'm looking for druids. And then I'm going to have to sniff out if they're healing druids. Because, I don't know. Looking at some likely names. Int is a good start. What are we using here? Are you currently spec'd into balance? In PvP, Keeper of the Grove, Call of the Elder Druid. Oh, interesting, okay. Is that true of these ones as well? Keeper of the Grove, Call of the Elder Druid, Focus Growth. Okay, so I need to change a talent around. Apparently that is good, because everybody's using it. You are currently spec'd into Resto, so I'm just gonna... Are they using more or less the same stuff? We've got a lifebound cap. We have a lifebound cap here? We do! Okay, we're getting somewhere. I'm getting a pen. So grumpy about... Why am I grumpy? Is it because I think this is harder than it should be, or is it because I think I'm not as smart as I need to be to do it? this is not the right kind of paper for this. But I don't have my other notebook here, so we're just going to write it down. Lifebound cap. That's going to be needed. Because that is one embellish. What else are we wearing here? Four piece. So there's tier, of course. We're going to want to catalyze some stuff. New four piece. Lifebound belt. That is a crafted belt with that comes with a socket. That they've gone for. They've also... I'm just looking for another embellish. Weird, okay. They still have the Infurious Foot Wraps. Are you using Infurious Foot Wraps? No, you've got Lifebound Boots. I think the cap is important. And then after that... Oh, Tabard. Well, at least the trinkets are straightforward. Insignia and medallion. We like to see that. Everybody loves a proc trinket. What's my second embellish? That's what I'm trying to figure out here. Obviously, we've got the cap. Those gloves have no embellish on them. It's really interesting to me that you would wear crafted gloves with no embellish. And the same thing, like over here, we've got crafted boots. Oh, hang on. Zone of focus. Hang on. Lifebound boots. Well over 90%. Mechster Master over 90% health. Mastery over 90% health. Okay, I don't remember what that's called, but the boots. I know the embellish mastery over 90%. I just forgot what it's called. Somebody in chat might know. Okay, so call those your crafted pieces. And then obviously we're gonna need tier. We're gonna need item level, because I bet you they're not gonna let me in right away. I'm gonna grab the talent real quick, because we want Call of the Elder Druid. So make sure we've gotta leave High Winds behind. When you shift into a combat form, Heart of the Wild for 15 seconds every 1 minute. That is insanely good. Okay. Blue silk lining. Thank you. Let me write that down. Blue silk lining. I'm sure I'm gonna need new sparks, and I am allergic to doing current content, so I'm probably just gonna hope that I get the sparks from PvP. You'll get them eventually, I think. It just might be kind of behind. Okay, and then what was my next question? I found my embellishes. I found my trinkets. I do need to do honor gear. You can't catalyze aspirant gear, can you? I think I'm just gonna break my old tier set bonus without stressing about it too much, because that way it'll be over with. Cap for helmet. But we could buy off pieces so that as we get conquest, we can buy main pieces and then catalyze them immediately. So I should be focusing with honor on, and it won't help me stamina, but non-set or crafted slots. Yes? So like bracers, neck, rings, belt, back, weapon. Weapon's good. Let's get a weapon, because that's going to scale. Okay, what kind of weapon were they using? They had, we've got great staff, or gladiators. That's a main hand offhand. And then that is, okay, so three different weapons. Haste, Versa, Versa Mastery, Versa Mastery. Okay, I think I can do worse than a Versa Mastery staff. Do we have a Versa Mastery staff? We have a Haste Versa staff. Crit Versa staff. Oh, it's a knife. All right, Haste Versa it is. That'll do. And I get an appearance. What's not to love about that? Okay. If I'm looking at my PvP window. Yes, new seasonal mount. And I wanted to get into solo shuffle. They're gonna be like, hey, excuse me, you need to get to 473 PvP item level. You last season piece of scum. So we need more stuff. At least I saved my honor this time around. That's the one good piece of news. Working on my pet collection the last couple days. Fairly new account, doing all the taming quests. Got my first 25 today. Nice! Want to collect transmogs? Maybe I should wait for War Within. Do you think they'll work retroactively? We don't know. My stance on it, just for myself and my own life, is that regardless of whether they work retroactively, I'm going to wait, because even if they did, and I was like, I'm going to farm all this stuff and hold on to it for later, that is an absurd amount of gear in your banks and bags, and I feel like it would ruin my life. I would rather wait just to not have to deal with that. And then trying to figure out whether or not you already have a thing. Like, maybe you get a thing to drop, and you're like, cool, I can learn this later in the War Within. You stick it in your bank, you get it again on a different character, and you're like, did I have one of these on my mage? I don't know. It's because it won't, until it learns, you know, it won't reflect as updated in your collection, so. And then there's always the chance that War Within does come out, and then it's not retroactive, and then you did all that for nothing. So, my take is that the efficient thing to do is just to pretend that we don't know about it until it happens. Alright, should we buy some? I might need to actually start, because these are like 450. I might need to start, whatchamacallit, can you catalyze? I'm sure you can't. Besides, I wouldn't want to use catalyst charges on it anyways. So I want to avoid helmet and boots and tier slots. We might have to gear tier slots, but I'll do them last, I suppose. So we need helmet, boots, and tier slots is like all of your gear. There's very few things that are not included there. Okay, a belt. So we could take Verse Mastery or Haste Verse. Let's make sure we have enough Mastery. Mastery is going to help with throughput. Okay. And then a cloak. Crit Verse or Haste Verse. We'll take Haste Verse for that. Throw that on. And then rings. So let's do haste versa. And do we have like a verse mastery ring? We do. Haste versa, versa mastery. Okay. Trinkets. Need a new medallion. Need a new insignia. Because yeah, we have lots. At least we have lots of honor. I saved up my honor at the end of last season for this. So we can at least get all of this stuff. I'm curious to see how what this does to my PvP item level. And then my new insignia. And then of course we want to do the traditional take your new trinket and put it on all of your druid bars. And don't forget any of them because they all matter in case you want a trinket in stealth. Okay. My goodness. And then get my old stuff out of here so I don't accidentally put it back on. I'm going to need new enchants, which is stinky. Is the stream available for replay later? Yep, it'll be available on Twitch as soon as the stream ends and for a couple of weeks, and it'll hit YouTube approximately tomorrow morning, and it'll remain there in perpetuity. However, I don't know if I recommend taking any advice from me. I guess the advice is on where to find advice, because I'm just ripping what I'm doing off of other people, more or less. What's my PvP item level up to? 463. We need to get to 470... 473. We need another 10 PvP item levels before they let us into Shuffle. Which may or may not be an exciting day. Let's find some bracers. Let's find some bracers. I must have missed them. Helmet, breeches, spalders, boots, gloves, grips, foot pads, mantle, leggings, mask, cord, arm guards. There we go. Versa mastery? Haste versa. Versa mastery. Haste versa. Haste makes your hots tick faster and it makes your cast faster. Yeah, okay, fine. Let's do some haste here. Haste and versa are both good. Mastery is really nice for throughput, but haste is helpful for emergencies and also throughput. Okay. 464. So now I have replaced both rings, both trinkets, belt, bracers, cloak. Let's get ourselves a neck piece, shall we? Nice little necklace. Because then we're going to start working on tier set slots, even though it's temporary, but we are going to have to do it. Where is the jewelry? Necklace, there we go. That one is haste versa, sure thing. Sounds good. I'm going to have to send her some gold for enchants, probably. And gems and all that jazz. Although, I don't think I'm going to bother to... Well... I'm not going to put anything super expensive on the green gear, because I'm going to replace it eventually. Hopefully soon, you know. That's... doing better. We have 6,900 honor left. Thank goodness I saved some, otherwise you would be watching me do battlegrounds right now. Oy. Okay. We'll do tier set slots next, and we'll just and it'll at least give me big item level chunks. And you know, transmog. Leggings. Do a mix, shall we? Get a little mastery in there. Besides, it's not like I'm picking my leaker. Ooh, I like the set. I like the look. Okay, we're close. We're doing good. Shoulders. Shoulders good. Oh yeah. Oh, we're looking good. We need two more item levels. We will be able to shuffle because we can afford it. And I suppose we have... let's do helmet, shall we? We are going to craft one of those, but... no, we'll do gloves, because we might be able to craft earlier rather than later. Because we just need the spark and then a bunch of gold that I can send over. Sure. 472, one more. So boots and helmet are my crafted slots, but I believe I've replaced everything else. I think I've replaced literally everything else. So, in light of that, we'll do a helmet. I mean, it's good. It's good transmog anyway. And now we should be allowed in. Well, now I feel bad that I don't have the boots. I feel like I may as well just buy them. Why not? Just get myself in all greens. I like how I agonized over which slots to do, and then I eventually bought literally all of the slots. Hey, we got an achievement! And we still got 2k honor left over. We could even buy more marks of honor to save for transmog. You can put back on your old tier set. I just want to get rid of it. I understand that's probably the good move for, like, effectiveness, but for my own peace of mind and cleanliness of bags, I don't want to switch back and forth. It sounds awful. I'd rather get rid of it, let go, stop playing with it, don't be used to it anymore, and then just be excited when I get my new set. Is it almost Saturday? Tomorrow's gonna be almost Saturday. Bloody coins quest for the week. Absolutely not. I haven't done any PvP this season at all. So yeah, I'm gonna be like a mess effectiveness-wise because I'm down a tier set bonus, I'm down all of my gems and enchants, and I'm also down both of my embellishes. I have no embellishes, no tier. I'll buy some enchants here. Let's see what the people were enchanting. We can do that. That person put mastery on, looks like, and that person did haste versa. Let's do a pair of mastery, two rings. Because those are pretty cheap. I'm not going to spend like 8k for a Sophic Devotion or anything like that, but I'll drop a couple hundred gold on some ring enchants just to feel like I've tried. So we want... I want Auctionator, actually. I don't want to shop with that Auctionator. Do-do-do-do-do. Love the green wig. Why, thank you. This is my Rusto Druid one. I want to wear this one when I PvP. Weapon could look really sick with a Primal Fire Illusion. True. I don't know if I'm going to leave her in this Aspirant set and play in that, or like Mog her to something else. Devotion of Mastery. Yeah, so give me two of those. For now. And then what else are we saying? Are settings cheap? Not really. not wildly cheap. Can I get a homebound speed for cloak? Yeah, it's only 85 gold. Let's make sure we get the good one. Can I have a reserve of intellect for chest? Can I have a medium reserve of intellect for 29 gold? Devotion of speed, I suppose, for bracers, apparently is what people are doing. Again, I'm gonna get a cheap one because I'm cheap and these are greens. What else do we want? The belt clasp, I think, is too much. Yeah, she's not spending that kind of gold yet, anyways. I will spend that gold when I get conquest gear. I just don't see a whole lot of cause to do it until then. So is that temporal spell thread? Yeah, it is. Because I'm going to suck anyways. So we made it like, we're just trying to mitigate. We're just trying to stem the bleeding here. We're not trying to... Wow, those... Fine. Medium temporal spell thread. And then maybe like a planeswalker's breeze? I thought I was already fast. Yeah, give me a medium plane breeze. This is one of my favorite things to do in like a fresh alt if I'm gonna actually take it into a dungeon or something, is even if you don't want to spend a lot of gold on enchants, you can get some enchants for like dirt. And just putting those on makes a big difference and shows that you mean business. Temporal spell thread. Proves that you're one of those people that's heard of enchants. We're gonna do boots. Bracers. So do I look cool or what? Yeah, I look all right. I might take the helmet off. Otherwise, how will people know that we match? So undo the changes, hide the helmet. Happy? Yeah, kind of. Maybe, yeah. I mean, it clips her hair real bad. But it's cool, but it clips her hair real bad. Maybe her hair needs to change. I'm getting off track. Barbershop visits are very important before you step into the arena. Vicious Moonbeast? It's the current season Vicious Mount. It's precious, and I need one. Love the new open leg skirt style. Mm-hmm. Who doesn't love... I mean, I'm sure somebody, but I love a good thigh-high boot. You gotta slay before you can slay. Exactly, you guys get it. Don't mind me being, like, incapable of accessing the mirror. So, I want her hair. I mean, I love this hair. But I kind of want it to not clip. The color is non-negotiable. I could change her to something else that won't clip the, It's not curly enough. That won't clip the thing. So the shaggy is what I had been using. That's funny. I thought I had been using that one. Still clips. That one has bangs. That one's got the undercut. I do have all of the vicious mounts except for this newest one. The new one is the one I'm missing. That's nice and out of the way, at least. Sometimes I use the braid. These new ones are really cool. It's not very me, though, is it? Top-knot. I like that. That's nice. It's not me, though. I can't do it. We can do the braid if we want it to be out of the way. Where did it go? Long braid. Pardon me. How about quickly race changing her into a worgen? Explainer on how to use details, more intuitive mod. What else do people use? Is Skada still around? Skada recount? I don't know if there must be a details primer out there. I don't know of one myself. I also struggle with it, but mostly once I found the buttons I need, I try to remember where they are. I don't use most of the features of details though. I am a very surface level user. Okay, all right. So we look sick. Did I finish enchanting my stuff? No, I got distracted by transmog. We're gonna put on the reserve of intellect. How do you get the mount? You need to PvP. You need to do rated PvP in either 2s, 3s, solo shuffle, or RBGs, or any combination. It can be any characters in your account. They all count towards the same progress bar. And you need to win games at or above 1k rating. So you gotta play a little bit to get there and then play games. My plan for the moment is to try to heal solo shuffle as a resto druid. The backup plan is to take my hunter, Faleria, and see if I can do some, like, YOLO BM hunter double DPS 2s or something? I don't know. Because I don't want to sit in a solo shuffle queue in a DPS, but, yeah. I also don't know how to play her to save my life. Tea toast and honey, thank you for the 16-month resub. Tough to estimate hours to get a vicious settle because it'll vary a lot based on what bracket you're in, how much you win, how long your queues are. I would not expect to do it within a couple of days. I would budget a couple of weeks at least, unless you're willing to like sit down and play all day every day. Look into rated BG, you just flex it. So I'm just going to use Heart of the Wild as a defensive. And I'm just going to send myself in and find out. I'm just going to send myself in. Oh, no, hey, they're going to bribe me. What was that accent? Oh, hey, leprechaun. They're going to call. I'm going to get bonus rewards. We love bonus rewards. So we're going to get bribed into shuffle. And I'm going to find out. I mean, I haven't changed into keybind since last season, and it was working kind of okay. It's still kind of a mess whenever. Does she have Barnicles' weak aura? I actually might not be mad at that. I might not be mad if she has Barnicles' weak aura. I mean, the BAMs might be kind of annoying, especially... Oh, you know what? Hang on. I need add-ons. I might miss my cue. Here, actually, let's leave the cue for a sec. I need to make sure my add-ons are on, because I updated them. Also, this is clearly stuck. Let's do a little reload. I need to make sure she's using all the add-ons that I like to PvP with. Struggling to get to 473. Yeah, there must be a good way to grind honor without having saved it up already. I guess battlegrounds, brawls, maybe comp stop question mark. Somebody might know. Add-ons. All right, I need. This is only if I'm trying hard. We're not trying hard. I don't need ability team tracker, for now. Big debuffs. Important. Big debuffs is very important. Otherwise, I can't see my debuffs because they're not big. I can leave that off. I'm not going to worry about details. Gladiator Losa and Gladius. Good. Need those. Leotrix, good. Omnibar, good. Plater, not necessarily needed, but I will turn it on. She can keep Plumber, that's fine. And she's got weak horse. Okay. Alright, let's go get back in queue. I probably could have still been in the queue and, like, finished that in time, but... Oh, there we go. Instant queue. We love bribes here at Hazelnutty Games. Speaking of bribes, I was trying to set up a sub-goal. First of all, figure out how. I haven't had a sub-goal possibly ever, or if I have, it would have been so long ago that I've entirely forgotten all of the details. But I wanted to set like a proof of concept one up for the mystery wig reveal for the debut of the third so far unspecified hair, because I thought that was fun but not important enough that anybody needs to get bent out of shape about it. And I set one up, and then I didn't put it on my stream. So maybe between games, like after this particular solo shuffle match, not round, but like the whole match, maybe I'll look into seeing if I can pop that on the screen. Warlock killed their fell puppy. You know how much someone would need to bribe you, according to your shirt? At least a buck. Okay. So there's a Dev Evoker. I don't know anything, by the way, so don't take advice on how to play for me. Dragon Rage Avatar. Yeah, I do have my weak horrors, but they might actually genuinely help here.
Power infusion.
Everything's gonna be fine. Ow. Maybe everything's not fine. Oh, my trinket. I put my trinket in my bear bar and my cat bar and my stealth bar. I didn't put it in my tree form bar. You've got to be kidding me. Next time I'm in tree form, I'm gonna have to grab my new trinket from my bars. Oh. Molly. Bam. 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 Get some threat plates. Oh, thanks, Data Pop. I'm still enjoying my buzz cut off stream. It's a good compromise because the wigs don't get that much wear and tear because I'm only really wearing them for this. Okay.
Dragon Range.
Okay, we are very far from me.
Fear.
I swear I did my bar. I did my. I put my trinket on my bars, but I definitely don't have my trinket on all of my bars. Here, we'll try it again. There's cat. There's bear. Maybe it didn't survive the reload. There's stealth. Okay. Try that. Doesn't require any setup out of the box. I might consider it if I get to that. Unspent dragon riding glyphs. Oh, my deepest darkest shame. I wonder why my add-ons are experiencing so many errors. I might need to I mean, I just went through. I just audited
Power
them all.
Infusion avatar.
So I want
Sol Rod.
Okay, well, the good news is we can trinket again. Do a half one of those, and... Oh, that totally blocks line of sight. I've never seen that before. What is that? Is that a Death Knight thing? Crazy. Alright, here, we'll spend our dragon riding quips. I think. If I can remember which ones they want from me. Just click on everything, madly. We have six. How? Oh, these ones. There we go. I do have an app for add-ons. I don't run it all the time, though. I don't let it run just passively in the background, so I have to launch it. I swear I did it this morning, though, before I started stream, because I knew I was going to do this. They should have... I'll run it all again, just in case. You never know.
Power infusion. Bam!
There is something to be said for losing your first couple matches to like really tank your MMR so you get the easy games. PvP talent makes deep breath, put LOS on both sides of it. Is the LOS friendly as well as, I mean, it must be, right? It must work both ways because the Evoker was on my team and I was struggling with it. And if they made a dragon riding PvP arena, I would actually PvP. Affects both friendly and enemy. Alright, well, I hate it. But that's just because it's new and I'm bad at it. Okie dokie. Bam!
Power infusion.
I haven't necessarily done a good job on that.
Sol run. Fear. Fear.
Bam!
So the bam means that I've let my life bloom fall off of myself, and it's important that I keep my life bloom up on myself.
Alright.
Bam!
I'm being so greedy. Too greedy. They died. RIP. I don't even know if you're winning or losing. We have won two rounds out of six. This is the last one. If I want to... Actually, I can't get any vicious map progress anyways because I have zero rating right now. We're just kind of warming up and playing for practice. Jacob, thank you very much for the 30-month reset. Search which your trinkets in your bard and tree form. I'm hoping the tree form uses the same bar as humanoid form, and it's just because for some reason the humanoid one wasn't updated.
Dragon range. Power infusion.
Bam!
Penitence. Penitence.
Good news is even for a loss, I'm getting a better rating because we're rated zero, so we're still getting off the ground. Got a phone interview for a new job in 10 minutes. Super nervous. Oh, I'm excited for you. The worst part of that kind of thing, because I feel you, that would make me like turn into a pile of worms on the inside of my body. Waiting is always way worse than actually doing it. Waiting is the worst part. All right. We get some bonus conquest. Am I going to continue working on my Tour of Duty achievements? I was doing a thing where I was getting, yeah, the honor. Oh no, that's with the honor tokens, not the conquest tokens. Okay. Yeah, bonus conquest. Thank you. I don't think I would have gotten any conquest otherwise. Oh no, I did have 50. Because we didn't win. Wait, it's pretty great. Get to watch Hazel. Good afternoon. Frozen Edmonton of negative 32 degrees Celsius. Helsan, I'm so sorry. Thoughts and prayers for your bones? work towards the malicious title, so you could be Malicious Boy.
Hey, kitty cat. Moral.
Who's complaining about our negative 10? I mean, also valid. It's gonna get to, I think, negative 8 here tonight, and I fully plan on complaining. I've been waiting to complain about this cold snap all week. It's been on the forecast for ages. And tonight it should hit, and it might start snowing. And I've been gearing up for a good vent. She could be Dennis the Menace. I'm not going for a Glad Mount, no. I am just looking to grind for a Vicious Mount, which is much easier, doesn't require any skills or anything like that. I wouldn't be mad at the Elite set. I did manage to get that last season and the season before that in Shuffle. But I'm not like, I don't have my heart set on it because I'm not really, I mean, it's nice, I guess. But that's basically how I feel, is it's nice, I guess. that's pretty much where I'm at. I don't know if I'm going to get myself bent out of shape about it. I mean, negative 20 Celsius Chicago next week. Winter is here. I know it's inconvenient and occasionally dangerous, but I'm kind of glad that winter like happened, because I was getting a little worried that we were just going to have bizarrely warm weather for the entire season.
Cyclone.
There are a lot of druids around here. I'm a druid. I've got a druid on my team. They've got a druid on their team. That's just quite a few.
Cyclone.
Bam!
Cyclone. Avatar.
That's what I wanted to do. That's right.
Bam!
That's better. Because now it's easier to see my teammates. It seems really hard to kill a Balancer. You need like 3v1. You need Cross Easy. The Cyclone announcement's so soothing. Cyclone. What worries you about bizarrely warm weather? Oh, unforeseen by me because I'm not a scientist, effects of climate change. Stuff like that throws off the whole balance of the web of life, you know? Like, some things that are supposed to die off in the winter don't. Some things that are supposed to wake up in the spring wake up early, and then they die, and then they don't wake up later. You know, the stone falls in the pond and the ripples are felt across the sea or something like that. Thursday vibes looking super cute. Thanks, Whip Whip. Had the first fly annoy me at work yesterday.
Bam!
Metamorphosis.
Oh, I see, I see.
The Hun. Cyclone. Cyclone. Power infusion.
Bam!
Oh, that's a lot of damage. Why worry about it if you cannot affect it? You know what? You're right. Any classes in particular that are easier to farm this mountain PvP? Made a brewmaster, but I hate Windwalker. I don't know. At the rating, like, you can farm this at a rating in which balance. Actually, no, I was going to say it doesn't matter. That's not true. I'm sure there are some classes that really overperform at, like, the 1K to 1400 bracket. But I just don't know which ones those are.
Incarnation Kitty. Incarnation Kitty.
Bam!
Power Infusion. Cyclone. Cyclone.
Ooh, that was a really good cyclone, offensive clump.
Cyclone. Cyclone.
Bam!
Cyclone. Cyclone. Penitence.
I don't know what penitence does, but I feel like I should know. I might want to look that up.
Cyclone.
Bam!
Cyclone. Cyclone. Cyclone.
Bam!
Cyclone.
Oh no! I was targeting myself! Cyclone. I was like cranking heals.
Cyclone.
And I'm extremely Cyclone. Healthy, and the warriors somehow managed to hold on without me for like 10 seconds under pressure.
Cyclone. Ooh. Cyclone.
Happens. It happens.
Cyclone.
Okay.
Cyclone.
I'm hesitant to CC because it kind of feels like Cyclone. They're just rotting everybody.
Cyclone. 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 Cyclone.
Bam!
Maybe you should play Diz to find out.
Bam!
Gladiator Losa is calling it cooldown such as Power Infusion, Alice. DH is beginner friendly, blow up everything, jump around like a squirrel on coffee. Mm-hmm. Wonder if anyone ever cast Cyclone. This game has four druids in it? Three druids in it? One, two, three. Three druids, but it feels like more. Thought I would contribute to the conversation. Cyclone. Mega healing myself two dungeons because I didn't notice that mouse overcast wasn't activated on this ult. Oh man. I would love to cyclone the Rengar.
Avatar. Power Infusion.
Bam!
Penitence.
That really does hurt. Oh, you know what? Oh no, it's working. I was gonna say my scroll wheel targeting's not working, but it is.
Bam!
That's Kira, Hazel's manager slash producer. That's the one.
Thank you again.
Excited to find you on Twitch. Love your YouTube raid guides. Gonna follow you on here also. Thanks, Obsidian Fire. Knocking the microphone around. So, Lunchador, I appreciate that you're trying to help. I'm not really looking for advice at this point in my life. We got an anti-backseating rule, as many streams do.
Incarnation Kitty. Incarnation Kitty.
Bam!
Power Infusion. Metamorphosis. The Hunt.
Ah! That's okay. I know you're trying to help. Oh, the triple druid team. Yeah, it's a set I was wearing last season. All the druids. Inversely enough, I don't think we're going to hear any Cyclone on Gladiator Losa because none of them are on the enemy team.
Avatar.
Bam. 96 rating. Gladiator Losa is doing spell reads. There should be a PvP section in my add-on spreadsheet here. But I'm not expecting to win too much. Eventually, once I get to 1k rating, I'm gonna wanna try! I'm going to hope that I can eventually start winning at least 3 rounds out of 6. For progress on the vicious mount, but until then we're still getting somewhere. Beginning of the season is always a bit of a rough go because I'm at a bit of a power disadvantage and also like a practice disadvantage. I haven't played since last season. I don't really remember where everything goes. Any balance changes are going to be new to me, and then I'm also down 2 embellishes and a tier set. Naranja, thank you for the 6-month reset. Happy half year. All of that's okay. It just means that I can't expect to go 6 for 6. Hazel, if you ever made a machinima, what would it be about? A machinima? If I made a machinima, I imagine it would be like a short story about somebody in WoW. Like a gnome living in Ironforge or something, just like living their life. It would be the slice of life anime of machinima. It would have very little to do with World of Warcraft, except for taking place inside of World of Warcraft. Any balance change is going to be new. Good thing. You're playing Resto. Good day, Hazel. Good day to you. I hope your Thursday is going well. Would watch the heck out of that. Doing good, doing good. We need those WoW stories told. Borealis would work too. That would be fun. Bear in mind, I don't know the first thing about making machinima. I make raid guides. It's different. I know how to put a cheap-looking text graphic up over some footage. Never noticed Night Elves had this kind of feet. It's the shoes. It's the boots from the set. They're pretty cool. You can do machinima raid guides. Hello, Hazel. Hope you're having an amazing day. Thanks, Illidari Nico. Would it be about somebody who once told you that life was gonna roll you? Listen, it's hard being a gnome. Everybody's trying to kick you. Can't imagine the dwarves would. My thing, the tool that I've never gotten the hang of, that is useful for making WoW videos, that I've never managed to get to work consistently for me, is Model Viewer. Partly because mostly when I need it, I want to look up new models with it and not older models, and trying to get Model Viewer to work with like a PTR version is apparently just hell. But even with old versions of the games, I've never really gotten my feet together with that. I've installed it like 5 separate times.
Power infusion.
So that's an interesting power infusion. I think we're just gonna line of sight it. they popped it already.
Power infusion.
Okay.
Penitence.
All right.
Bam!
Hold your horses. Veins. That's icy veins. There's an ice block or something. Sit in that. For better or for worse, turn to being that. My big debuffs aren't as big as I remember them being. So, my DK's on blue.
Icy veins.
That was a brave and potentially unwise move.
Infusion.
Oh, I've completely forgotten to use Keeper of the Grove at this point. Mind you, it doesn't seem like it's gonna save their life. But it could. Oh no! It was going so well until it wasn't. That's okay. Legit, have never gotten this map in PvP. Didn't know it existed. It's a fun one because over here, it's me. Did I pop Adaptive Swarm or is it still up from last time? Need to be told. I've been told that I need to forsake my mouse over heels, opt for macros. It depends on the context. If you're doing like arena, then yeah, I would agree with that. But for everything else, mouse over healing, I think, in my subjective opinion, is king. It's like real good.
Metamorphosis.
Okay, so let's just kind of take it easy.
The hunt.
I've lost my mage. They're over there.
Metamorphosis.
Move meta. Let's just kind of do this. Give you a couple of these. My target-to-target frame sucks, because it's blocking half my hot, so I can't see my renewal stacks. Or my blooming, or whatever the life bloom thing is called.
Bam!
There we go. That's a good CC. That should help. Kill somebody! Do it!
Metamorphosis.
Uh-oh.
The Hunt.
Oh no! Yeah. Alcarva, thank you for the 13-month resub. Happy Thursday, Hazel, Kira, and Moose. Yeah, party 1, 2, 3 macros is kind of the move. I have done the thing where I have party 1, 2, 3 macros, and I have put party 1, 2 and then self macros, and I have them on my scroll wheel so I can change my target with scroll wheel, which works awesome except for when there's pets because it scrolls through the pets even with the macros instead of the keybinds. It drives me bonkers, and it wouldn't do that if I had a really gentle touch with my scroll wheel or if I had them on a key where I wouldn't like double mash the key. But, alas,
power infusion.
I'm just not that good. I've never managed to find comfortable keybinds for them.
Power infusion.
I mean, that's fine. Right?
I see things.
I'm just gonna heal and,
metamorphosis.
Hope for the best over here. Oh, nope, they're dead. RPGs are fun. I'm glad you like them. Think Kira's sitting to the side coaching? Possibly judging? Hard to tell with cats. Yeah. The scroll wheel thing didn't used to have that behavior, but it's had that behavior for the last couple of patches, so I really should have found a better solution by now. Because yeah, if I'm just scrolling, and I'm scrolling gently, I'm just toggling, which is great, but if I scroll too hard, now I'm targeting the hunter pet, and I'm not targeting anybody, and that's not helpful, especially in an emergency. So I should probably just move them onto keys. But like, gross, you know?
Power.
Especially because it's not like I'm flooded power with extra keybinds.
I see them.
Bam!
Polly.
It wouldn't hurt to pull back.
Penitence. Polly. Polly, I see veins.
An interrupt? My goodness. Somebody's pressing their buttons.
Bam!
Polly.
Bam!
Polly. Pillar of Frost.
Grant her an honorable death.
I didn't mean to do that. I have a keybind for, oh, I forgot to do the thing. Anyways, I have a keybind for bringing up the score screen, apparently, and I, on occasion, hit it, and I really don't mean to. Yeah, unbind that. It's like shift and spacebar or something. I don't think I've won any rounds yet. Got two
power
more.
Infusion.
They really love PIing just on opening doors. And it's like, we're playing too. We're like, okay, sure. I guess if you've used your cooldown, it would be a shame to let you burn it.
Penitence. Metamorphosis.
Bam!
Pillar of Frost.
Bam!
The Hunt.
Grant her an honorable death.
Bam!
Metamorphosis.
I also could have sworn I turned on big debuffs, but my debuffs don't look that big. It's helpful sometimes for something like Mind Games, where you might not see it on the frames, but you really want to dispel it as fast as you can. Hmm.
Bam!
One more round of this. I should probably... Oh, hey. I should probably... do Emerald Dream weeklies. Just because they're really fast and easy. And because I think the rep weekly would give me like a spark. Or at least a half
power
a spark.
Infusion. Power infusion.
I need a couple sparks. I just need two. I can make my hat. And, oh, well, alright. I have to pick my favorite teammate, I think. You appear to be the one taking all the damage. Hey, look, we won one! I still got 96 rain, and we got 25 conquest! And a hazard payout. Alright. I wanted to, first of all, use Mag Metal. Gave me another one. We like this. At least the healer keys are giving me conquest catch-up. I don't have enough to buy anything yet, but I want to keep an eye on, I want to keep an eye on the prices so I can see what my first pieces that we're going to buy are. Because, yeah, you sell conquest stuff. We're going to do set items first. Yeah, we'll need 875 for the first piece. And those scale to 489 in arenas. So that'll be helpful. I think... I mean, it's not going to help me very much. No, it is going to help me. We should pick up the weeklies and just have a go with them to see if we can get together a spark together. Just so that we have something. Plus, it'll scale. How are we doing rating wise? We're up to 384. I like the constant call to arms. That's nice. That's something. Using this automatically skips a campaign. Although I did just miss the super bloom, so maybe we'll just pick up the quest in the queue a little bit more. The slight adrenaline reaction I get from that one sound notification sounds like the first half second of a Minecraft creeper igniting. Gonna miss hanging out here when I return to work. Much appreciation, Hazel and friends. Yeah, I wonder if I should tone down my weak wars. I don't know. They're not really telling me anything that I don't need to know, though. It is still very important to keep your life bloom up on yourself. So there's the worthy ally. That's what we need to do.
What brings
and then some seeds. And then we'll pick up a super bloom weekly, too. So I think I might need to... For the seed weekly. Actually, the seed weekly is not for... I mean, it's still a good idea, but it's not for.
Well, life rep. Is all around us. Greetings.
Buy some cheap seeds. Yeah, send me back in. Have you seen the vicious moonbeast today? Have I seen somebody else on it? I know my title is Have I Seen It. I want one. I want this. I'm setting up my grind to work on one. It doesn't look like it's going well yet, but that's okay. We're having faith. Sparks retroactive? The catch-up is. you'll be able to get extra sparks. Oh, I'm in war mode. I forgot. Oh, I should turn that off. That's funny. Yeah, you can get ketchup sparks. Oops. Owie. Moonbeast. Oh, there is a Moonbeast mount. There's a shot mount that I apparently have and I've forgotten about. But it's the vicious one that I don't have. That's right. Well, we still need it.
Mortals,
see, when you get the thing out of the caches. Winning's a bit of a big ask for me right now.
Many in the cartel are wagering on who.
That's okay. We're also fixing our MMR. I'm currently coasting off with some MMR from last season that's kind of doing me dirty right now because I'm behind in gear and practice. So all this losing while we get up to 1k is bringing our rating down so that I can hopefully fight against some other people that are of a similar level of chili fingers.
Sleepwalk. Icy veins. Polly. Ascendance. Dragon Rage. Polly. Sleepwalk. 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 Hex.
Bam.
My own bed.
Ascendance. Icy veins. Sleepwalk.
Victory is clear. Our bargain is up.
Wow, Noob, can't believe how expansive it is. It's a huge game. You can play it. Take it from me. You can play this game for years and years and years and years and never need to do the same thing for longer than you feel like it. If you enjoy enough different spheres of it. Good news is as I scrape together the conquest and the sparks and whatever to like get my gear cut up, I should feel some of that in throughput.
Do not let the cartel down.
Because we'll get used to how it feels right now wearing nothing. That's a cool mount. Spectral Tiger. Whoa, they found the rogue.
Bam. Victory is clear. Our bargain is upheld.
I think this is a cool map. Oh, we juked a couple kicks. But not enough of them because the rogue's on me.
Bam! Victory is clear. Our bargain is upheld. Bam!
Polly,
no matter who wins, we profit.
Okay. Everything's fine.
Polly. Ascendance. Evasion.
Bam!
Polly. 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 Hex.
Bam! Bam! No matter who we
Who's your favorite WoW character? I like Kelsey Steelspark. I think she's cool. We haven't seen her in a while, but that's because she's too busy to be on camera. She's too busy to be on screen. see if we can pivot.
Do not let the cartel down. We expect a return on our investment.
Bam!
No matter who wins,
they killed somebody.
Profit.
Good job, team. Every once in a while, somebody does something without my input at all, but you still get credit because you were on the team. You were there. Oh, maybe I should start her out with like a little baby title. She's a farmer, and then if she earns Challenger, we'll stick her in Challenger. Or there's one below Challenger, isn't there? There's a conjurer.
Do not let the cartel down.
I don't remember.
We expect a return on our investment.
Bam!
Hikes, sleepwalk. Dragon range. Sleepwalk. Ascendance.
Thanks, Cassie.
Victory is clear. Our bargain is upheld.
Bam!
Sleepwalk.
I should probably just go sit back behind that pillar where I'm expected to be. Stop. Stop, wandering out into the wilderness.
No matter who wins, we profit.
Bam!
Sleepwalk.
Victory is clear. Our bargain is upheld.
Bam!
Sleepwalk. Sleepwalk.
Bam!
Dragon range.
I feel like I'm running out of ideas. I hope that we kill somebody soon.
No matter who we are,
bam!
We profit. Victory is clear. Our bargain is upheld. No matter who wins,
we did it! That was a close one. Oh, sound effect's kind of funny. Green wig looks much more like a wig than the pink one did. It's very vivid. The pink one is more of a dusty color, and it's also quite shiny, which makes it look pretty wig-like. It's really close to the color that I had my hair dyed to, at one point in my life though, which makes me kind of nostalgic for it. Do you enjoy the Tree Bros? Am I specced into Tree Bros? I should hang on a second. I don't have a keypad for Tree Bros. Hang on. Because, yeah, they're good. They're real good. Alright. Well, the good news is I'm not spec'd into them. The bad news is I'm not spec'd into them. It's good news because I haven't been using them, and it's bad news because I feel like they're good? Unless they got removed or nerfed or something. I don't know.
Bam! No matter who wins, we profit.
Ascendant.
No matter who wins,
bam!
We profit.
Thanks.
I've done better work. Where? So, that's my demon hunter. That's my mage.
Bam!
Thanks. Ascendance.
Bam!
Victory is clear.
I'm very far. I'm extremely far. I don't think this one's gonna work out.
Bam!
Trees are good. Get the trees. Embrace the trees. I thought I had the trees. I don't have the trees. Why don't I have the trees? I'm getting the trees. Get the trees back. I don't know if I'm supposed to have wild synthesis for them as well, but we're gonna take that for whatever reason, and then we're gonna get that there, and then I'm spec'd into Heart of the Wild, and I never press it, never ever ever.
Do not let the cartel down. We expect a return.
Press A to craft. Thank you very much for the 22-month resub.
Sleepwalk. Thanks.
Bam.
No matter.
Dragon wings.
We profit.
Ascendance. Sleepwalk. Sleepwalk.
Bam!
That was a decent window on the rogue, potentially.
Sleepwalk.
Victory is clear. Our bargain is upheld.
Ascendance.
Bam!
That's the healer trinket.
Sleepwalk. Dragon range.
Bam!
Devoker damage coming out.
Bam!
Rogue's looking for a re-stealth. And you got it. Oh, there you go. Alright, well, good news is that I managed to use all my mana. Bad news is I managed to use all my mana. How do we do? Hey, we went 3-3! It's worth 200 conquests! We win, technically. 937 honor, some extra rating. What's not to like? I don't know about PvP, but they're nice in PvE healing. They were great in PvE healing last season as well. One thing I totally forgot to look at when I was looking at talents was I wanted to look at talent details. And I wanted to see can I just import so it keeps you in Keeper of the Grove and it puts you in all kinds of stuff. I'm gonna Vortex instead of Entanglement because I prefer that just as a comfort thing. It gives you Germination. Still with Undergrowth and Photosynthesis. You also get Trees. I don't know exactly what I'm losing, but I'm gonna try these. I'm gonna try these talents. I'm also going to, I think, take a short break, and when I come back, then I shall have returned. BRB. Kitty's been waiting to steal my chair.
Excuse me. Whoa.
There we go. That's better. I don't know any grouping discards. I also don't have the new tier set yet. I don't even know what it does. I'm not very close to my mount. I'm at 0%. We gotta get this number up to 1k before this number starts ticking along. However, all of this healing solo shuffle. Even though we're not winning a whole lot, we're still making progress because that number's going up. And then also, I'm getting stuff. Marks of Honor, Whispers of Dreaming, Consortium Letter. Sure. and then the hazard payout. So we're getting bonus conquest. We have lots of honor, but we're in full honor gear. We need conquest gear. I also need sparks. I'm also going to turn off Wormwood so that if I do go to, if we do go to the Emerald Dream to do the weeklies, then we can not be in Wormwood over there. Alerting all adversaries. Deliver the leaflet. What is this for? I don't think I've heard of this before. Oh, in the Gladiator's Refuge. Okay, I see. Does number ever go down? Below 1k, I believe it cannot. I think the only time your number can go down is if you're above 1k rating. Oh, I see. That's for something different. So that's the good news, is that even if you have the worst day ever and you do nothing but lose, the only thing you're really risking is your time if you're pursuing a vicious mount and gear. If you're pursuing like a glad mount, then yeah, you're in trouble. Okay, so we have two trophies of conquest that we can use for our two spark items. That's kind of cute that they just give them to you. That's nice. Verdant and Greater Verdant. Oh, I see. So there's different ones for different slots. Why? Why are there two? What is the point of that? For what? For who? Anyway, I know which pieces I want to craft. I just need sparks. I need dream sparks for that. The question is, do I want to try... we'll do another round, because that'll get us pretty close to Super Bloom time, and we can do the Super Bloom. What about my dignity? Can't be bringing things like dignity into this. Sorry, video professions in gold making. Can I ask you a question about weak wars? You can ask. I may or may not know, but I'll do my best. And if I don't know, maybe somebody in chat does. They're good for that. Oh, water good.
Kitty, you gonna stay there? You comfy?
Maybe these new talents will be good, because I can double rejuvenate with Germination. We still have Verdant Infusion. I kind of want to get out of Mark of the Wild just to get anything else, because I'm not pressing Mark of the Wild. I know it's awful, but if I never use it, then it's a waste. I could have literally anything else. I mean, I could take Protector of the Pack, and then I could just Moonfire once in a while to do some extra damage. Frosty Beers, thank you very much for the 15-month resub. How to use Tama's Dragonflight Helper? I basically just installed it, I think. installing Tama's Dragonflight Helper includes lots of different things. And I basically deleted everything but the profession module. It should track your professions automatically. To be more specific, I googled Tama's Dragonflight Helper. I found a Wago page. I got an import code. I imported it. And then I stuck it over on the side. But there's no special setup. It also tracked a lot of other things that I didn't need, so I just deleted all those modules and left the profession one alone. But you can certainly use the other ones too if you like. Any good donut places up there? No! Which is, Empire Donuts, I think, is the best one. And they're pretty good. And I think they supply donuts to a couple of local coffee shops, which is pretty good. But to be honest, I've just kind of stopped eating donuts. After I left Portland, it seemed like there wasn't really a point. There's really good bakeries that do patisserie. So there's Patisserie Daniel is a really good one. And then there's also one that does like little pastries. There's a little pastry shop that I like. But I don't do either one terribly often. I just make bread at home. How's the weather? Is it windy? We had like two straight days of like really strong winds to the point that they were closing some of the coastal streets because the waves were just coming out of the ocean and push all over the road. I didn't go, but I like saw the footage from, I saw some news footage. And the wind's done now, but we're going to get a cold snap. Think Tama's redoing it. Wasn't able to download it. Oh, that sucks. loaded everything, bunch of stuff to do. Monkey brain can't handle that much. Yeah, just I would just go through and find all the parts that are not relevant to you right now and just delete them. All right, we got rogues. We got... Am I not specced into Mighty Bash? Why not? Oh, I'm specced into Incap Roar. Okay. All right, that's fine. I can do that. My fake bangs are in my eyes. That's no good. Donut situations like my cheese steak one, it's hard to find a good one unless I do it myself. Yeah. I also realized that donuts didn't make me feel very good after I ate them. So it's not like I don't indulge, but... Meow. Yes. I think the talents that I had for the first handful of games today were not really doing me a lot of favors.
Evasion.
Bam!
I think I want to kill this talent. Oh, I can't. I'd have to kill something else too. We need renewal, despite the fact that I don't use that. We need that. Because you'd need another point into Well-Honed Instincts and then Protector of the Pack. And I don't think there's anywhere good that I could kill a point. What if we kill this one and this one? Oh no, you need that one. You need one of the ones up there. Never mind. Dallasite is named for Dallas Road? Really?
Avatar.
Dallas Road's a beautiful walk. You just gotta watch it for cyclists.
Bam!
Avatar. Dragon range. Power infusion.
If I'm ever visiting the island, definitely going rock hunting for Dallas. It's got a neat look. Had a gourmet shop cater our wedding instead of... Oh, a gourmet donut shop cater our wedding instead of cake. Oh, that sounds incredible. That's how a wedding should be, you know. Traditions should only be involved if they bring you good feelings. Like, they should only be involved if they make you enjoy them, basically. Like, I would love to go to a wedding that had catered donuts and a mac and cheese bar. Holy moly. Donuts should be the tradition.
Bam! Bam!
Sleepwalk. Power infusion.
This was a really risky, really, really risky trinket.
Dragon range. Evasion.
Bam! Bam!
Sleepwalk.
Bam!
Sleepwalk.
We did it! Donuts are wedding ring shaped after all. Indeed, indeed.
Bam!
I should pick out a new bread to do today. I finished the last of the sesame whole wheat bread. I want to try more of these, like, what do they call them? Country breads? It's kind of like a cross between a white bread and a sourdough in that you don't have, like, an ongoing sourdough starter. Although I would like to start babysitting one of those again, I think. Oh, this is going to be double rogues. Although we already have the three wins we need for technically a win, so we'll get some good points out of this.
Power infusion. Power infusion.
They're probably going to want to do a fear, but... Sorry, my bad. Queen of PIing people's DPS targets. This feels a million times better. I can't tell if it just dropped my MMR into games that are more fitted to me, or if the talents are really making that big of a difference. Because my gear didn't change at all. I mean, I love blaming me some gear, but. I think people are letting me get away with a lot more. But I have time to get away with a lot more because it feels like my heals are, like, working. Why have I opened all the things? This is not what we wanted to do. Oh no! arrogance. The fall of us all. No. You get a flat amount of percentage if you get three or higher. Winning more rounds doesn't get you any more percent for the vicious smell. More foolish friends. Mom made some fresh egg bread a couple days ago and the bread maker was so good. Making me craving everything bagel with all this bread talk. I made potato bread last week. Gone in a day. I don't think I've ever had a really good potato bread. And there are recipes in this book for potato breads. Maybe I should try one of those. Find out what all the hype's about. Do you need glasses? The optometrist? The local optometry shop in Victoria. Dispel that. The glasses I had before this some years ago were from Herman Miller. Warby Parker, and I liked those too. I was happy with that.
Dragon range.
Ooh, they're dead.
Bam.
These ones I'm really glad they are they've been holding up because I thought I was gonna be like super gentle and kind to my glasses. I don't know who I thought I was. But I thought that, man, you're getting nice grown-up glasses, you're going to be really careful with them. And it turns out that even when I'm really careful, I'm still occasionally quite careless, but they haven't been meaningfully damaged yet, so knock on wood. And then after this, we should be ready to, like, look into a super bloom.
It'd take like 20 minutes.
Bam! Bam!
Probably shouldn't have set that too, but anyway.
Bam! Bam!
Evasion. Avatar.
Bam!
Penitence. Avatar.
One thing I really never do is I never use Incap Roar to peel.
Bam!
Oh no! Oh, it was so close. Yeah, I could stand for this to be at like 1200. It would make my life a lot easier. 287 ratings, some conquest, some honor, and a box. I don't have any contacts, no. I've never had contacts. I don't think that I would hate the feeling of wearing them, but I just really like the way I look with glasses. I could see the appeal of maybe wearing contacts for like running, because I will go for runs without my glasses because it's just comfier, but then also I can't see very well. I can still see like cars coming, but details would be really no good. You know, you'll pass a cute dog and you'll never know how cute it is. But I'm not running enough to really justify getting contacts just for that. Or if you were gonna like, I don't know, swim and you wanted to be able to fit your contacts under your swim goggles and still be able to like see at the pool or whatever. Okie dokie, we have 637 conquest. We got some more honor points today. We got our rating up to 959, so I have managed to make it basically almost up to 1k. The next Q session I do should start working on a vicious mount. I'll have a vault. Actually, I need to play a little more so I get at least two vault options. I forgot about vaults! I should have been doing this the whole time for vault loot. Ugh. I'm the worst. Anyway, let's go pick up the Seed Bloom Weekly. Do you still want to put the subgoal on screen? I'm like on the fence about it. Cause like, I guess I could try just, no, I don't want to. Oh, I don't know. I'm reserving judgment, I guess. Important to see cars when running, but you also need to see crows and ravens. I had a dream last night that a crow or a raven, it was a corvid, I couldn't tell which one. I think it must have been a crow. But it was landing on my hand, and then it was like pecking at like my cheek, like pulling the skin from like right about here, trying to like get a hole, I think. But it didn't really hurt, and I didn't really mind. And I felt like we were friends, but it was definitely trying to burrow its way into my cheekbone. And there was, and it felt significant, but to what extent, I can't really remember. Dreams are weird, you know. Okay, so we'll pick up this.
Welcome. I appreciate.
I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do like the world boss and maybe a couple of dragon races first. So just to get a little bit of extra rep and, you know, a little extra rep and a little extra time killed, basically, because the Super Bloom, you can do it in the last like 2 minutes. Swim and not having contacts makes for a blurry session.
This new foe is too powerful to face alone.
So let's get ourselves into a group for world boss if we can.
Remove this threat.
Sometimes I think, like, you'll see the boss attacking like those NPCs or whatever, and I'll think that somebody's fighting it. So I'll be like, oh cool, somebody's already engaged it, and then I run up to it and I like hit it with a moonfire or something. And then I discover, nope, we weren't fighting it. That was just the NPCs, and you are now fighting it all by yourself, all alone. No good.
Your efforts have brought us together in triumph.
What a rep! Chance at some transmog. We must always keep an eye out for the Claws for Concern world quest, because I need a pet still. There's a couple of pets that I'm still looking for. I need to do the satchels for Tobias, the community rumor satchels. And I need to do Gurgle, I think. Like, there's a blue murloc that you can, that's part of like a, one of those minor secrets that they added a million patches ago. And I just, for whatever reason, never did it. But I'm missing a pet. That just won't do. Can't have all the Gale spirits and I'm missing Gurgle. It's no good. And I'd like to get all my pets like upgraded too, like leveled and quality upgraded and stuff. Which I think is just a matter of logging onto the character that has all the pet charms and going shopping. I think that's probably... You could make an argument that I should save my stash of pet charms for when in the future they add more pet charm pets. Because, I mean, that's worked out for me so far. I got the one in Zerolite Caverns just automatically because I happened to have enough pet charms left over. This is a really swoopy course. I, like, don't want to use any extra speed boost. There we go. Now we're on a straight shot. Because I don't really want to go any faster. I'm going to hit something. Just like that. Last evening, got the Bakar companion from the hunts. After three repeat Ohuda companions, I never have to do the hunt ever again.
Nice. Competitors.
Congratulations. I'm panic checking to make sure I have them. I wonder if I bought one of them or if I got them both to drop if I got lucky. Spurs. Why you can even get repeats of a one-of-one uncageable pet's beyond me. Mm-hmm. It seems pretty rude. Just collected enough tokens to buy the rotten apple for the next mount. Oh, nice. There's a project. I have that one ahead of me still. I do want to do it. I just don't know when.
Aspects gray shine down.
Got my Lego axe. It's so OP. Congrats, Seventh Sin. That's incredible. There is a hazelnutty voice pack add-on. It is moderately out of date, but it still works as I understand. I'll hit it with an update one day. Useful if you want to have my voice yelling at you during your raid night, and awful otherwise. I can't turn it on. I think it's the most cursed thing that's on the internet. Farm 2 tier sets a week per class. Got almost every class tier from vanilla to BC complete now. Holy, that's nice. That's a lot of farming. It's brave. I aspire to have a transmog collection that complete one day. I have a lot of priest sets, but I think that's the only place that my transmog collection is even remotely noteworthy. And it's not like I have all the priest sets, I just have a bunch of them. Legion was good for motivating you to do that. Yeah, props to anyone who can do it. Were the Grand Hunt pets always available? They were always there, I believe. I don't think they got patched in. They were just not a super high drop rate, I don't think.
Nicely done.
Yep.
You and your Drake are
1,000 gold to buy some cheap enchants. It is 5 minutes. We could kill another 5 minutes before we go to the super bloom. Maybe plant a few seeds. I don't think I have any dewdrops, so we might not be able to get the rip. If I heard my own voice talking to me while raiding, I'd think it was a bit cursed too. Oh, it's not only my voice, it's my voice from the past. I recorded the first version of that voice pack years and years ago. I don't know how many years and years ago, but a long time ago. It was in the early days of Patreon, which I haven't even had for a couple of years. And I was on Patreon for a number of years. It was like a early Patreon goal to make a voice pack. And it has lived on ever since.
Really?
I wonder if what I'm going to do is I'm going to PvP this week, fill out two if not three vault options, and then not spend any conquest until next week when I have a vault so that I can, because I would hate to spend conquest to buy my first piece and then to immediately have that be like the thing that I get out of vault. I guess if I need everything, there's not a whole lot of risk of that, but still. Used up a different pitch. Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, part of it is just getting older. People will sometimes sound different being 21, 20 versus 31, which I am now. But I used a gnome-esque tone. I was very squeaky. It was cute. It was just pretty extra. I found it to be effective for me at the time. Remember the DBM voice narrating the fights? Doing LFR, maybe it's not narrating that much anymore. Maybe missing some settings. There may not be as high a density of mechanics. The raid fights have gotten a bit simpler in the past couple of years, especially within Dragonflight. They've become a little bit more straightforward. So DBM might not need to tell you as many things, but it may also be a setting. Yeah. I'm not really set up to do damage on this druid. After this, I'll go hang out with the super blend. Because I do want to get the weekly done. I just don't want to follow it around for an entire 20 minutes. I would love to get at least my first little scrap of progress on my vicious mount. But that's going to mean at least 2 more rounds. And I would have to win the second one. Otherwise, it would be more than that. I do a fairly good male gnome voice for fun. I can't not say inventory is full without imitating my gnome mage. Is your inventory full often? That's a line you know by heart. You get a decent amount of dewdrops from this, actually. I was very... I underestimated the power of dew for some time in this patch, because I was like, what's it for? You know, maybe you get some more flight stuns, but the trick is that if the... You have to fill the bar up to at least half. You have to fill the dewdrop bar up to half. Ooh, I got a cosmetic! We got the shoulders from the mail set, that's nice. Send that to my evoker or something. Cool. If you want to have rep from your first 5 seeds, or if you want to have rep from the seeds, you need to contribute to some that get over half, and sometimes that means you have to sink your own dew in to make it happen if nobody else is around. Shall I plant another one, but then just kind of leave it be? Hear it a lot? May or may not be. Digital hoard. There's nothing wrong with that. Let's go check in on Spruce Crown, shall we? See how he's doing.
The wildlife here has
I'm excited to see Avarice again. Frenzy. Not so much Vault of the Incarnates. I've kind of forgotten Vault of the Incarnates. I vaguely remember Sinars. But Avarice was a really cool raid. Just noticed. I have almost 1,000,000 channel points. Holy. It's quite a few. Whatever are you going to do with your bounty? I need to make sure that I contribute at least 50 bloom. Shouldn't be a problem. I love being a druid for super blooms because flying around in flight form makes it super comfy to just like pull weeds and water the flowers and whatnot. You can also be shockingly far from the tree when you do it. I used to think you had to follow the tree around and just do the ones in the immediate vicinity, but it turns out a ton of things that you can do for bloom. Well ahead of the tree and also well behind it. Raz is gonna be rough to relearn. Oh man, Razageth, that's right. Have you thought about onions? Why do we love the taste? What eats onions besides us? It's a good question. Stanley and Holes. Last night, I saw a documentary on the history of garlic. Oh, you're living right. That's how you do it. Alright, so we have our 50 bloom. I'm gonna get my gear sorted out eventually, one way or another. Been there since 10,000 BC, and there's ancient Egyptian recipes with garlic mentioned. Oh yeah, I didn't pick up the PvP weekly quests. I should check to see at least what they are. Depending on what they're asking from me, I may or may not do them, but when they're asking me to solo shuffle, it would be silly of me to not at least grab them. I heard somewhere the onions were used to preserve other food, and we just kind of got used to the flavor. I mean, I can only speak for myself, but I don't think onions taste like food until you've cooked them. I think that cooked onions are amazing. Raw onions are not for me. Pickled onions, very good. Uncooked, unpickled, they're just not my thing. Also, deters vampires. Bam! Red onions are the ones to eat raw. But I don't like eating those ones raw either. I like that I do cook with the yellow ones because they're very affordable. They're one of the cheapest foods I can buy is medium yellow onions. Drop will be live starting on the 16th. You got 5 more days to wait and then they start. I had an ex who used to eat an entire raw onion, like an apple, with a block of cheese. That would do a number on your bread. Love red onions, especially the sandwich. I'll usually, if I'm ordering something that comes with raw onion on it, I will try a couple of bites with the onion as the chef intended it to see if I agree. And then if I don't agree, I'll just take it off. It's easy, pretty easy to remove, which is nice. It's not a big deal. And I'll usually give it a try just in case I like it. Because once in a blue moon, I'll be like, if it's just a small amount of it, I'll be like, yeah, okay, I see why this is here. But most of the time, it just hurts. Use a lot of onion powder. But the pickled onions thing really surprised me. I was having, what was it? I think it was a taco place that put like these really delicious pickled onions in the taco. And they were so good that I was like just eating handfuls of them. Hey, is it good to see you? Where I'd followed you before. Well, good to see you now. Like raw onion, pico de gallo, other salsas. Don't know why I'd unfollowed. I blame Twitch. Have I tried onion jam? I haven't, but that sounds really good. Tomato jam is one of those sentences that sounds awful. But some of the best veggie burgers I've ever had in my life were served with like a tomato jam. Or like a sun-dried tomato jam. I feel at that point we've taken food a few steps too far along the processing pipeline, but I don't care, it's delicious. It's really good. I had a thing when I was a kid for making French onion soup. I don't know why, because it's never been something I've craved as an adult. I think the idea was that I had encountered those little, like, onion soup powder packets that had, like, the desiccated onions in the powder. And you would make broth out of those. And I think maybe that was one of the cheat foods that I bought when I was, like, first buying groceries for myself with, like, not a lot of money. And then at some point I was like, I could make onion soup. And I was like, there was a few different recipes that when I was a young person I, like, took it into my head to try to work on, and that was one of them. But I haven't made it in a million years because I don't remember liking it very much. I just like got obsessed with trying to make a good version of it. But it wasn't like I didn't like onion soup, I just kept making it. Oh, there's always onion at home, I guess. Toasty bread and cheese on top. What were the other things I used to make? Like not as a young adult, but as like a teenager. I had this one recipe. I was trying to do rice pudding for the longest time. And I made some really nice fresh rice puddings, except that every time I made rice pudding without fail, I would burn it onto the bottom of the pot that I was trying to make it on the stove. Make sure we tag Anne here. I would burn it, and then I would have to soak the pan for like 4 days. I think I got in trouble a few times for that, because it would always burn horrifically onto the bottom of the pan. And I haven't tried it since. I love rice pudding, though. Maybe it's worth another go. I hate my cooking. It's either the most perfect, miracle-tasting, awesome. I have a feeling there's another part of that sentence. Absolute trash, never know. I bet you're a much better cook than you're giving yourself credit for. I've been giving myself bonus points whenever I cook just because I made it. I've decided that I'm just gonna like things that I've made more because they're from me. These are Hazel Kitchen exclusives, and you can't just get food like this. This is the only place in the world where you can get food made by Hazel. And even though that's like me, it still kind of works. Okay, so we did the quest. That's good. We're going to turn it in.
We shall work also good. Together.
Hey, I got transmog. We like transmog. I'm not going to put it on because it does not scale for PvP. So we won't worry about that. See about maybe popping some... Oh, actually, so she's starting fresh with rep, which means that she's going to get tons of rep from using like this token. So yeah, she's got her Dream Warden's rep weekly done already. It's if you finish the rep, then you have to kind of scrape up your rep weekly a little bit because you lose the benefit of those alt catch-up bonuses. But the rep weekly is really easy to do if you've got like brand new baby rep. So that gives me a splintered spark. Okay, I have a half a spark. We're halfway there. And I apparently needed that transmog, so there we go.
Feel free to browse.
And then what do we want to do? We want to get rid of these veteran purples, because we don't want them. We're wearing PvP gear.
Goddess, watch over you.
I appreciate that I'm pretty sure you upgrade your greens for outdoor item level with flight stones now and not with honors. So I don't have to, because before I would just never upgrade my PvP gear because I was like, I'm going to save that honor to get marks of honor to get transmog. Why would I upgrade this stuff? Because like it didn't matter for PvP. It was just for outside. But now this is kind of nice. It still won't matter for PvP. The item level in PvP is the same. But if I end up with like a ton of flight stones, I can pretty safely just dump them into my gear. That's a good change. I'm happy about that. Shall we? Deliver? Dream seeds? 5 dream seeds? I could plant a few more dream seeds just to get the blooming weekly done, just to get a piece of transmog, I suppose. I almost don't want to get the rep on them now because I don't need it for the weekly. Yeah, my priest has been flightstone capped for like weeks and weeks, and she's just been full clearing the raid and just burning flightstones, and it feels bad. But you know, it's raid night, you gotta bring your main.
The wildlife here has been driven into a dangerous frenzy.
I wonder if they're gonna adjust that in any way for the War Within. Oh, okay, that worked. Because it feels pretty bad. Trying to learn mage again? Arcane, vastly different now versus the mob is. I know that feeling. I always get like weirdly indignant about it. Like, how dare you change something since 10 years ago or however long it's been? How rude. You should have left it precisely as I remember it. It's usually how I feel. One thing I don't really do at all. I guess I don't need to. We're farming vicious mounts. I'm not pushing raiding. I don't do any damage in arena. I will occasionally slap like a moonfire on a rogue or something, and that's pretty much the end of it. Still not over the rest of your changes. On one side, I have this policy where I just don't look at changes anymore, apparently. I see balance notes and I just kind of skim right over them because I just kind of have faith that everything's going to work out. And the upside of that is it means that I'm pretty much never stressed about being buffed or nerfed. It doesn't really enter my radar, so I never feel bad playing my class when it's been nerfed because I usually don't know that it's been nerfed, and it usually hasn't been nerfed so much for me to notice on my meters, so it's like fine. But the downside is that sometimes I'll log in and my talents are all different and I'm like, what did they do now? Because I like didn't do the research to figure out what it was ahead of time and figure out how I felt about it. I just like, they always blindside me because I never follow balance changes. So whenever they actually like change talents or they change things to the point that I need to change talents, I'm the last person to know. I don't think I'll change because I think that the peace of mind from being blissfully ignorant of balance is still worth it for me, but oh, it's annoying sometimes. Log in and all your buttons are gone. They're like, excuse me, we moved your talent points around. It's important for balance. Will you stay near the minimal rating? I'm just going to kind of play. I'm not going to try to push and I'm not going to try to tank. I'm just going to kind of end up wherever I end up. I wouldn't say that I'm going to game especially hard. But I'm not going to try to cheese it either by like throwing games to stay at a lower rating. I'll just make myself feel better by if I lose horribly, I'll tell myself we were throwing to stay at a lower rating. But in actuality, I probably tried. Frostmage wrecked the meters. Fully mythic plus geared. Still top 10. Mm. Yeah, helps a lot. Okay. Can I buy with my seed bloom any weapons? Any weapons that I don't know yet? There are four more. A warglaive, a sword, a one-handed mace, and a pike. Ooh, let's buy the pike. That's kind of cool.
Be careful.
I'm going to get all that transmog, I swear. And we're going to send the male shoulders to... Both my evoker. That's why not. And then anything happen here? More transmog. I'm getting lots of transmog from this epic set, the crystalline tender
walk
stuff.
Gently on the earth. My goods are of the highest.
I'm not wearing any of it, but it helps a lot. Oh, my puppy's dreaming. I can hear him woofing. Woof, woof, woof. I swear he sounds like a zebra when he's sleep woofing. It's so cute. We have to do at least one more round just to get two vault options. We must. Wish my bags were that clean and empty. I mean, this life can be yours. You just have to ruthlessly delete things and or vendor them and or post them on the auction house. I'm pretty sure I've done this already. So I can delete that now. The half a spark we definitely need. The ire we can sell. Although I will say, having a Brutus sword makes it a lot easier to clean your bags from the fly. Because if there's something that you do want to post, you can just kind of chuck it up on the auction house. Am I saving up Marks of Honor for like a weapon set or something? Or did I want to buy PvP sets? I know I'm collecting transmog just in general, but... We have, of the PvP sets for Druid, I have most of them collected. I'm pretty happy with this. Actually, I probably have more Druid PvP sets than I have Priest sets just because of having done this for long enough. Some of them I earned when they were current, but a lot of them I've just bought with Marks of Honor. What if I need Zyras Disguise when the time comes? True, you never know. This drives me nuts because apparently you cannot buy these pieces individually. So if I want to finish this set and make it 9 of 9 and not 8 of 9, I must spend the tokens to buy the entire set all over again. Silly. I wonder if I can buy that. Or if that's not available. Cruel Gladiator's Dragonhide. Oh, never mind. Cue popped. Would the Aiding of the Accord give me a catch-up spark? I feel like the Aiding of the Accord doesn't give you anything good anymore. Although once I get my spark, I'm gonna have to figure out... Oh, well, all the pieces and bits I need, and the missive, and the embellish item, and the materials, and the work orderer, and the crafter, so to speak. Never remember where sparks come from. The main source of spark has always been the rep weekly, at least for the last two patches. It was the loam rep weekly when we were in Zerlit Caverns, and now it's the Dream Warden's one. But if you're behind on them, you can get them from all kinds of stuff. LFR is probably the fastest thing to do because they have a really strong chance to drop from bosses if you're behind. So if I just like healed an LFR, I would probably get enough sparks to make my PvP stuff. I'm just being stubborn because I don't want to heal an LFR. Alice, thank you for the 39-month resub. Appreciate it. I feel extra druidy today. I thought I was so clever when I was putting on my deer sweater and my green wig. I'm basically a druid. Surely this will help me win. I could drop Heart of the Wild for Ursine Vigor. It's such a good defensive cooldown. It's also an offensive cooldown if you ever were smart enough to use it like that. I just have never felt like I've gotten good enough at Rested Druid to really like spend a bunch of time doing damage in addition to all the healing and CCing and avoiding CC that you're doing. Turn into a bear. Oh, you know what I could probably stand to do? Is I could go customize my forms. I'm just in like default night elf forms because I thought that was kind of cute. But we could put out on other ones. TVK Joe, thanks for the 5 gift subs. Very much appreciated. Grass those who picked them up. Welcome to Thursday. Hope you're doing well. I am starting my shuffle journey. Oh, look at that big old conquest cap. Cyclone party.
Indeed.
Oh yeah, once we get to 1k rating, I can go from being farmer Evaleria to combatant Evaleria. That's the word I was looking for, was combatant.
And the clash of your weapons will be heard.
55 be the number. You don't like 55?
And the fallen will join them in the afterlife.
55 is a great age. You start qualifying for things sometimes. 55 is when you start qualifying to purchase homes in retirement stratas. There's a lot of places that I look at that I'm like, oh, this is kind of a cute place. You know, the furniture's a little dated, but that's fine. You know, they're bringing that with them. And then I see that it's like a 55 plus place. I almost called it a settlement. An elder settlement. But they're usually more affordable. What are we doing? Where are we going? What's happening? I like the dinosaurs.
Oh, are you a hunter?
Bam!
Dragon range. Sleepwalk.
Doesn't feel like we're on the Devil Curse.
Cyclone.
Maybe we were. There's an enemy druid.
Cyclone.
Maybe I'll pick up some tits.
Cyclone.
Bam!
Grant her an honorable death.
At least we're hitting the right target right now. That's a helpful. No! It hurts so bad! Mexican restaurant near me has 55% off food Monday through Friday for people 55 or older. Monday through Friday is really generous. I thought it was just going to be one day. Yeah, we did our best. Pretty cool set. I kind of like the Aspirant set better than the Conquest set. I usually wear the current season Conquest set while I'm playing in it, but I don't know. Oh, I wonder if somebody's AFK'd. Or if maybe my friends are just... No, my friends are just
Dragon range. For a second.
Oh, okay.
Bam!
Cyclone.
Don't mind me and my all the things keybind that I really should disable for this particular character. Maybe I should just turn off all the things for my PvP druid.
Bam!
What have I done? What am I doing? Where am I going? Who am I?
Cyclone. Cyclone. Nullifying shroud.
And honorable death.
Nullifying shroud.
Couldn't tell you what's going on. We're
Cyclone.
Just pressing lots of buttons.
Nullifying shroud.
Oh, forgot to specify 11 to 3, but still a great deal. It really is.
Nullifying shroud.
That's a bit strange.
Cyclone.
Grant her an honorable death.
Cyclone.
I think someone with Blizz switched Aspirin and Conquest appearances by mistake.
Bam.
Aspirin looks better for mail too. I think they just wanted to make the world sets look really nice because it's the same models as like the set you're getting for like Super Bloom and the Emerald Bounties and World Quests and like there's a ton of colors of them. It's
Cyclone.
A lovely set, but I think the appeal of the Elite set is maybe just missing me a tiny bit.
And honorable death.
Oh hey, we did it! But we have lots of sets we can wear. I'm sure I can put something else on. That's what the season one set looked like? I forgot about that. Do you remember anybody walking around looking like that? I do not. This set was awesome. Mind you, I always took the helmet off, but like that set was sweet. The shotgun sound is related to my adaptive swarm weak or it's telling me to recast adaptive swarm.
Cyclone. 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 Cyclone.
Oh yeah, I need to turn off,
Cyclone.
Turn off nameplates for like minions and miner and stuff because all of the ad nameplates and stuff tend to really overwhelm me.
Cyclone. Cyclone.
I did it! Have you voted on the season 4 stuff? I did. I only voted for priests because I don't... I guess I play other classes, but I just trust the people that play them to make good choices, I think. Hazel must have stopped stream and raided a Call of Duty player. Yeah, the default... I mean, I could change them, but... I'm kind of getting used to the default stats from that week or back. It's going to be hard to play Druid without them. I voted for Season 2 Look and Season 2 Bonus for Priest, although I wouldn't be mad if the Season 3 Bonus for Priest won, because I do enjoy it. I just kind of... I didn't get to play much with the Season 2 Bonus. I was still an Evoker main, and it sounds kind of fun, although I know there's some balancing issues and, like, they nerfed some stuff, but... I don't know. It looks like fun. What are we doing here? What am I doing? I'm hanging back.
Bam!
Cyclone.
Bam.
We trusted the WoW community in general to make good choices and then had to run Grim Rail Depot for a whole season.
I am wary at best.
Yeah. What was fun about Grim Rail? It was fun watching people die to the fire in the run to the last platform. I mean, it wasn't good for time to key, but it was funny. It was short, actually. I feel like it was one of the better keys to run in the season that it was in.
Metamorphosis. Cyclone. The hunt.
I don't know if we're just gonna have to be over better. But they're not okay! Every once in a while, your DPS go in two different directions, and there's not a lot you can do about it. Whew. If we're lucky, maybe we can get one win. Yeah, I'm hoping they recolor them. It would be strange if they didn't, right? Although it does mean they're gonna need like another three colors on top of the three that they already had. I'm just gonna stay down here and I'm gonna trust that if the hunter gets into trouble, they come back.
Metamorphosis, dragon range.
And honorable death.
Oh, that'll work. Hey, look, we're a combatant. I don't feel like I did much today, but we did achieve things. So that's proof that you just have to play if anything else. 3-3, you get the honor, you get the conquest, you get the extra vault option, we get some boxes. Yeah, good enough. It'll work. That gives me an even extra conquest, because that was my call to arms bribery satchel. And then that is for winning. Man, I was hoping that... Oh no, we have a splintered spark from something. So we can now make a spark. And then I can get myself a thing crafted. Yeah, we can get something crafted. At least one piece. Won't hurt. How's our conquest doing? We are up to 875, so I could also buy a conch piece and then catalyze it, but I think I'm gonna sit on that until next week. I mean, I guess it's only like Thursday. We're pretty early in the week, but if I sit on my conquest this week... Oh no, I need everything. There's no point sitting on it yet. I can get a piece, and I'm sure even if I have that exact same piece in vault, I have at least two vault options, so there'll be something else, and we need everything. The only way it could hoop me is if I get the same piece that I buy in one slot and then, like, the other slot is, like, a trinket that I don't want to wear or something like that. Or, you know, a piece that doubles up in the crafting slot. Maybe I'm talking myself out of this. Kinlay, thank you for the 5-month resub. 6 more colors. I guess I hadn't thought about the PvP sets. You're right. That's a good point. I was just thinking of the raiding ones.
You are in for a treat.
Mm. What is the one that I want? I know I want Lifebound Cap of the Interrupt one. Oh my word, there's so many of them. No, not that. What is it called? So I need Silken Lining in one piece. And I need... Statuette of Foreseen Power, that's the one. So if you successfully fate cast, you get a, I need to make a thing that has this, okay. You get a buff for successfully having fate casted.
Have anything ancient to trade? Needs to be at least 2 centuries old.
Now, gold for scene power. That's 4,500 gold. Half my gold. And then, Windsong Plumage. Another 1,000. Mire Slush Hide. I'm not going to make it, like, right now, but I think, I just want to get this stuff so that... That's only 70, even though it's 150 leather, it's only 78 gold worth. And then I'm sure I'm gonna need a missive to make it. What are the stats I'm looking for? Versa Mastery. Versa Mastery?
Have anything ancient to trade?
Draconic missive. Shopping for crafted gear is like my least favorite thing in Dragonflight. Of the entire expansion. There might be something I dislike more, but I don't know. I think this is it. Harmonious.
If you find anything exotic, bring it to me.
And then we'll use the trophy on it too. Yeah, for whatever reason, they didn't used to do this. It used to be that once you got Conquest gear, it would be at least on par with the new Honor gear, if not a little bit better than it. So you would get new Conquest gear every season, but having to go through Honor every season instead of just between expansions is like a Dragonflight thing that I could live without it, but we're doing fine. We'll get caught back up.
My goods are crafted with great care.
I will get that set up eventually. I have at least the stuff for it. I got lots of honor. I am really glad that I saved up all my honor at the end of the season, and I came into the season with basically a full honor cap, because that let me queue for solo shuffle today instead of having to do like some battlegrounds or something. Honor did roll over, so like they didn't reset your honor, so I was able to use last season's honor to buy this season's honor gear. It's strange the way it works, but I guess I'll take a win wherever I can get it. Because it didn't used to be. They used to reset honor, like they would cash you out. I thought they did anyways between seasons, but yeah. Now that we're up to... Oh, we're up to 1241. Our next win, we should start working. We should start scraping away progress on our vicious moon beast. I don't know when the season ends. I don't think it's soon, but I feel like we're going to be glad to have started this early. And it should only feel comfier as we go, because as I continue getting more gear, I should be a little bit more powerful. Honor gear is... 415, 1 of 8 greens. You could upgrade them to full explorer level, but they scale to 476 in arena and battleground, so you would need to be like, you know, like heroic raid geared if you wanted the gear to be competitive inside of PvP with like basic honor gear. And then once we get Conquest gear, that stuff scales quite a bit higher. 489, I think, which is tough to compete with even if you have PvP gear. I want to gear and push with Evoker because it's an Ozdormi armor. Looks hella cool. Nice! Alrighty, I'm going to wrap up for today, but I'll be back with a brand new fresh stream tomorrow morning, and I will post this one to YouTube. Stream VODs usually, assuming I don't forget, hit my YouTube channel for VODs the following morning. Yeah, honor gear is worth buying. Honor gear is worth buying if you're going to PvP. You want to get yourself into honor gear and then work into conquest gear. Here's a link to my VOD channel if you wanted to watch streams while I'm not available and also have them be on YouTube. I appreciate you guys very much. Thank you for watching, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye.